Clint Eastwood is an iconic actor, director, and writer. He has been a pioneer in film, not just in westerns, but in nearly all of his projects. He has contributed more to movie industry and been in more movies than most, but for now, let's enter in on just top 10 Clint Eastwood films. So, let's look at top 10 Clint Eastwood movies. Number 10, GRAN 2008. Retired auto worker and Korean War vet Walt Kowalski feels emptiness in his life towards fear and home repair, despising the mint and teen as he learns he has more in common with his neighbors than the thought.
The gangs are out.
What are you gonna do, Walt?
Whatever it is, they won't have a chance.
Number 9. The Bridges of Madison County, 1995. A moving love story about a photographer on assignment to shoot the historic bridges of Madison County. He meets a housewife whose husband and children are away on a trip, and the film traces a brief affair that is never sorted but instead one of two soulmates who have met too late.
There are images that lie within my heart.
Warner Brothers presents the most passionately read love story of our time. Clint Eastwood, Meryl Streep. The Bridges of Madison County.
Number 8. The Outlaw of Josie Wells, 1976. Josie Wells watches helplessly as his wife and child are murdered. A union man led by Capt. Terrell seeking revenge, Wells joins the Confederate Army. He refuses to surrender when the war ends, but his fellow soldiers go to hand over their weapons and are massacred by Terrell. Wells guns down some of Terrell's men and flees to Texas, where he tries to make a new life for himself, but the bounty on his head endangers him and his new surrogate family.
He lives by the gun. He lives by his word. And he lives for revenge. He's an army of one. Clint Eastwood is the outlaw Josie Wales.
Number 7. In the Line of Fire, 1993. A Secret Service agent is taunted by calls from a would-be killer who has detailed information about the agent, including the fact that he failed to save President John F. Kennedy from assassination. The caller is revealed as an ex-CIA assassin, and an agent who is investigating a threat to the current president is determined not to let history repeat itself.
That's not gonna happen.
Number 6. A Perfect World, 1993. Butch, an escaped state prisoner from a Texas jail, kidnaps Philip, a young imprisonable boy, as they embark on a trip across the American Southeast together. A surprising bond grows between the convict and his captive. Even as law enforcement forces slowly catch up with them, an honorable Texas Ranger, Red Gamut, understands Butch has a heart of gold, must pursue him anyway out of duty to the law and a desire to protect the child.
Kevin Costner.
You're not bad, are you, Butch?
Oh, yeah.
Clint Eastwood.
At least now I know who's in charge.
In a new film by Academy Award-winning director, Clint Eastwood.
You ever ridden in a time machine before? Out there? That's the future.
A perfect world.
Number 5. A Fistful of Dollars, 1964. The man with no name enters the Mexican village of San Mateo in the midst of a power struggle among the three Rojo brothers. And Sheriff Jones Baxter, when a regiment of Mexican soldiers bearing gold intended to pay for new weapons is waylaid by Rojo brothers, the stranger enters himself into the middle of the long simmering battle, selling false information to both sides for his own benefit.
Our mistake. Work often.
This man with no name is played by Clint Eastwood. He's going to trigger a whole new style in adventure. A Fistful of Dollars.
Number 4. Dirty Harry, 1971. Cop Harry Callahan attempts to track down a psychopathic rooftop killer before a kidnapped girl dies. When he is found, Harry abuses the murderer's civil rights, putting him back on the streets. Once he is released, he hijacks a school bus and Harry must go after him again. The only way to stop his vicious killer is in cold blood.
This is about a movie about a couple of killers. Harry Callahan. And a homicidal maniac. The one with the badge is Harry.
Halt!
Number 3. The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, 1966. In the Southwest during the Civil War, a mysterious stranger, Joe, and a Mexican outlaw, Tuco. From an uneasy partnership, Joe turns in the bandit for the reward money, then rescues him just as he's being hanged. When Joe's shot at the noose goes awry, giving one escape, a furious Tuco tries to have him murdered. The men greet him abruptly, however, to bait out a sadistic criminal and the Union Army and find $20,000 that a soldier has buried in the desert.
$1 Million Baby, 2004. Frankie Dunn, in a veteran Los Angeles boxing trainer who keeps almost everyone at arm's length, except his old friend and associate Eddie, scrap iron through it when Maggie Frizzled arrives in Frankie's gym. Seeking his expertise, he's reluctant to train the young woman, a transplant from working-class Missouri. Eventually, he relents and to form a close bond that will invisibly change them both.
Mopping floors, washing dishes. You know what the last thought is? I never got my shot. You know what the last thought would be? I think I did all right.
Number 1. Unforgiven, 1992. When prostitute Delia Frisfield is disfigured by a pair of cowboys in Big Whiskey, her fellow brother workers post a reward for their murder, much to the displeasure of Sheriff Little Bill Daggett, who doesn't allow vigilantism in his town. Two groups of gunfighters, one led by aging former bandit William Money, the other by the florid English Bob, come to collect the reward.
clashing with each other and the sheriff.
If you leave money out in Missouri, kill women and children.
That's right. I've killed women and children. Killed just about everything that walks or crawls at one time or another. And I'm here to kill you, little Bill.